So in this video, we are going to introduce a new algorithm for classification, namely logistic regression. And we will also learn what logistic regression has in common with the perceptron, namely that both are single-layer neural networks. So in fact, there are actually different types of methods or models that you're already familiar with, and we can actually describe them as single-layer neural networks. If you are familiar with linear regression, which is the method for regression analysis, this would also be a type of single-layer neural network. Or in other words, we can see it as a single-layer neural network, as we will see in this video. Also, similarly, the perceptron that we talked about in the previous units would be another form of single-layer neural networks, next to logistic regression, which is the star of the show here in this video. Yeah, so to define the general structure of a single-layer neural network, we have this overview figure here, which should remind you of the perceptron algorithm. However, here we have a more general annotation where we have the input weights, the bias unit, the weighted sum, and then an activation function and the output. So this is the general structure of a single-layer neural network, and this structure maps to all of the three ones that we just mentioned: linear regression, perceptron, and logistic regression. So if you are not familiar with linear regression, don't worry about it. However, if you are, so linear regression can be seen as a single-layer neural network where the output is a continuous value. So the perceptron that we covered in the previous units has a very similar structure, except that the output now is not a continuous value, but a class label, the class label 0 or 1. And this is exactly the same structure that also logistic regression has, which also outputs a class label 0 or 1. But be aware, the name logistic regression may sound like that it is also a regression method, but in fact, logistic regression is a classifier, similar to the perceptron. Yeah, and in the upcoming videos, we will discuss this more closely, but as a sneak peek here, so the logistic regression activation function would be a probability score between 0 and 1. Then to extend this visualization a little bit, I haven't shown you this before, but there is actually also a threshold function here, which checks whether the probability score is greater than 0.5 or not. If it's greater than 0.5, the logistic regression model will output class label 1, and if it's smaller or equal to 0.5, it will output class label 0. However, if this sounds confusing at this point, no worries, we will be diving into this in more detail in the upcoming videos. But yeah, just to finish up this discussion of the activation functions, so if we think about linear regression, what would be the activation function in this case? So in linear regression, we have an activation function, which is an identity function. This is actually boring because this means the input that goes into this function also comes out of this function. So this is really just a placeholder function that returns the value z at this point. However, I added this activation function here so that you can see how linear regression is related to other types of single-layer neural networks, like logistic regression and the perceptron. In the case of the perceptron, we have an activation function that is a threshold function. So here, the threshold function returns class label 1 if the weighted sum is greater than 0, and otherwise it returns class label 0. Note here that there is a difference between perceptrons and logistic regression, where in the perceptron, the activation function is the threshold function. In logistic regression, the activation function is followed by a threshold function, as we will see in more detail later. So here's this logistic regression activation function, which is also called logistic sigmoid function. And it looks very complicated at first glance, but yeah, no worries. We will look at this in more detail in the next video. But as we can see here, it's a nonlinear function where we have a term 1 over 1 plus e to the power of minus the net input. However, what's important to highlight here is that this activation is followed by this threshold function, which checks whether the activation is greater than 0.5 or not. And based on that, the class label is then determined. So yeah, let's have a look at this sigmoid function in more detail in the upcoming video.